So that's the rose garden mulched. That was hard work, but it looks great and it'll keep the moisture in. It's raining right now and it's been raining all summer, but it'll stop the topsoil getting washed away. It'll help to put nutrients into the ground as it rots down and keep the weeds suppressed. So yeah, I think it's looking good. I'm going to go in for my lunch now because it's raining. So I'm really pleased how the rose garden has been going. I mean, this rose here, as you saw, I had to put it into a bucket. I cut the bottom off. This bucket already had a hole in it. But this one's been flowering constantly, and it just, something, the stalks just don't seem to be strong enough to hold the flowers up, so I've had to put the bucket on. I'm hoping that after it's pruned in the winter, that next season's growth will be stronger, because there's a nice strong bit there going up, it's got buds on it. Yeah, so this one here has finished flowering, but as you can see, it's got new buds. It's going to flower again. As is that one. I think that one might be done. And that one might be done. But this orange one is flowering again. And has buds, and try not to trip over the fence here. I've had to put a fence around to keep the chickens and the shrews off. This one is going to flower again, and this little one here, it's got buds on. So fantastic! And over there you can see all the poppies that we had are still flowering.
Thank you.
So I've made a bit more progress with the dry stone wall repair, which it's kind of more difficult to repair a wall than it is to build one from scratch, I think, because you've got to work with what's already here. And these big stones here are called through stones, and they kind of tie the two outer skins of stone together, hold it together. And these little bits in here are just fill, but you can't just shove them in any old how. They've got to go in to stop these ones from wobbling, and so you've got to chock them in to make it nice and tight. This bit here is all missing down there, so it's really difficult to I mean, these through stones should really, I don't know if the wall was a lot higher, but they're usually a bit lower down, and then if it's a higher wall you have two lots of these at different levels. But these were already on this level when I took it down, so I'm just gonna put them back. But you see the top stones aren't very far, not very far to go, so yeah. And it looks like I've got a lot of stone here, but it's difficult to find the right ones to fit. That's the you've got to have a lot of patience, I think. You've got to look at it as something like that you're not really going to rush. Just try and just be relaxed about it. But yeah, I learned to do dry stone walling on a course I went on when I was in my 20s, early 20s. And I did farm fencing at the same time. But I haven't done much, I have to admit. I haven't done much of it. So all the dry stone, professional dry stone wallers out there, look away. But I'm doing my best, and I think it might hold up. And I am quite enjoying it, to be honest. yesterday the battery ran out on the camera and you didn't see me putting these pot stones on from here. There they are, and just need to get the rest of the wall up to level and keep putting the top stones on. Yeah, I'm hoping I've got enough, because you never do. They just vanish, don't know where they go. But I'll try, and if I don't have enough here, top stones that is, and other stone, I've got more over there where we took the wall down. So yeah, I think, fingers crossed, I might get it finished today. I think I've been working on it for 4 days. Well, not all day, but yeah, it's a slow process, but I think I'm getting there. Okay, so I've just been digging up some more top stones which have been buried down here. I think they've fallen off this corner. I'm going to have to take the ivy off there and fix that. But as I was digging them up, I found this. Look at that. Stone. Shaped stone. Is that part of our lost tower? It could be. That is interesting. It's got a chamfered edge. Could have been a window. I don't know. What is it? It's part of something very, very old. Well, I've just had to spend a good deal of time trimming the tree. Look at the branches. Because this corner of the wall is also collapsing. Wow, the more I look at them, I'll have to stop looking. The more I look, the more wall I find that needs repairing. Anyway, the tree is a massive lime tree. They send out lots of side branches from the trunk. They don't have a bare trunk. And it's grown into the wall. It's kind of, I think the wall's okay there. You can see here, I've cut these bits off, been pushing these stones off the wall. This one's collapsing this way. Look at the size of the stones in there. I keep wondering, you know, are these stones off our old tower that we used to build walls? Because we have actually found a stone that we know was off the tower on the end of this wall. I'll probably show you that later. But yeah, it's one of those jobs that you start and it never seems to end. But I might as well do it while I'm here and get that fixed up. And look at this stone. Look at the shape of that. There's another one there, and they're all like that along the top. Right. Back to work. So this is the bit that's been giving me trouble because it's the end, obviously, but there's a spike sticking through from this iron post, a bolt sticking out down here. So I had to put a bit at the back and I couldn't find a bit to fit here at the front. So I've just temporarily chocked it in with these until I can find a piece that fits nicer than that. But in the meantime, that'll hold it all nice and tight. Just an awkward little situation there. So, done a lot of tree trimming today and ivy cutting, and obviously I've had to fix this side of the wall, so still got the rest to do. And that new bit that I uncovered at the end, got that to do as well. But it's a lovely evening. I might go and have a cup of tea and come back out, but my battery is almost finished, so I'll charge it up and see how much time I've got.
Some tuna, we've had some milk, haven't we? Some new milk. Good one.